Net neutrality is a concept that's been getting a lot of attention. That's largely a result of changes made by the Federal Communications Commission that go into full effect next month. Those changes mean that internet providers could charge more for certain types of content and throttle access to specific websites as they see fit. To find out more, I discussed the ins and outs of net neutrality with computer science professors from UMass Amherst and Springfield Technical Community College.
It's become more of a political term than a technical term, so it's tough for technical people to describe it properly. But essentially, it's the fight as to whether or not ISPs will have the ability to manage traffic. And when I say manage traffic, that would include upgrading traffic, making it faster or making it slower or blocking it outright.
And when you say ISP, that's where you're getting your internet from, your internet service provider, right? So that could be a Verizon, it could be a Comcast. So this issue, as you said, has become more of a political issue than a technical issue. Any thoughts on why you think that is?
We see two different a spectrum of industries behind the opponents and proponents of net neutrality. So we have, on one side, we have the cable companies, and on the other side, we have the content providers. And I mean, somehow they have different political opinions, and I believe this is what's kind of made neutrality such a kind of political problem.
And it's a relatively new issue. I mean, this became a thing back in 2015 when the Obama administration decided, you know, we're going to level the playing field, as they described it, for this concept. But then we saw more recently when the new Trump administration came in, the FCC decided to come in and say, you know what, no, we're going to take this restriction away. Do you see this as tech versus telecom, or do you think about it in a different way?
Well, in the tech versus telecom, I agree there's the content providers, as Miriam was saying, and there's the ISPs, the internet service providers. However, you also have to keep in mind that the ISPs also are content makers as well. Comcast owns NBC, right? So they're in competition with Netflix, and Netflix is using their network to make money. So as any kind of decent company would say, wait, we're providing a service, and another company's making, our competitor's making money off of our service, that's a problem. And so what happened was the Obama administration and the FCC under them defined the ISPs as common providers or common carriers. Which would put them in the same restraints as telephone companies. That's the actual clause we're fighting over. And Netflix wrote a letter to the FCC, said, we lost customers when Comcast throttled our traffic, right?
So basically, it's kind of, if you think about it as a highway, right, it's whether or not the speed limit is set at 25 or 50.
Yeah, exactly. You can think of it as if you're driving in a highway and there's different speed limits for different brands of cars. So like if you're driving a BMW, you could drive up to, let's say, 100 miles per hour, but then if you have other cars, it's only, let's say, 50 miles per hour.
I think with the highway analogy, you have to keep in mind, though, highway is a function of government in this country, right? The highway in this case would be privately owned, and then competitors would be using that highway to deliver, you know, there'd be commercial traffic. So that's really what the fight's over, right? And as far as what would actually happen, if things were to stand and net neutrality was repealed, I think what would actually happen is it happened on the back end. The telecom companies are not dumb enough to, you know, create fast lanes and slow lanes for customers, because customers would be irate. What they're going to do is they're going to go to Netflix and they're going to say, you're going to have to pony up some money because you use this amount of bandwidth, right? And the grand concern would be it would stifle competition. If you had a brand new version of Netflix, some kind of person that built a, you know, a brand new compression engine that could deliver video over the internet that was better than Netflix, would they have the money as part of their startup capital to pay off the ISPs?
Exactly. I see two problems with the lack of net neutrality. One is that smaller companies won't be able to start their businesses because say they won't be able to compete with Netflix, because Netflix has a lot of money to offer to Comcast and Verizon to speed up their connection, right? And the second problem is with the freedom of speech and like internet freedom, because without neutrality, Comcast, Verizon, these broadband companies can just censor any content they want, right? Because there's no rule, there's no act protecting them from doing so.
And at this point, these are hypotheticals, but these are serious concerns that many people in this country hold, which is why I think we saw Senator Ed Markey lead the charge a few recently, and the Senate did overturn this. Now, the House is going to get involved in this, too. Whether or not the House will be able to block it in the similar way the Senate does is right now sort of great speculation, because it would take almost 20 Republicans. As we look at the deadlines, the FCC, the initial changes that were made began April 23rd, but those are really small changes. The larger issue here is June 11th. Do you think that the government will be able to step in, the House will be able to step in and make a change here?
Probably not. And even if they do, it still has to be signed by the president. However, some of those small changes, by the way, do have implications for the customers. One of those changes was they can actually now log your DNS requests.
What's DNS?
DNS is the domain service, so that's what translates google.com to an IP address. So they can keep track of what web pages you've gone to. There is some concern that this whole net neutrality fight is a smokescreen to do other things in the background, like those minor changes that you were talking about.
One other quick question, an area that we hear a lot about, to your point about privacy, data privacy. We saw Facebook and Cambridge Analytica. That drew a lot of concern among the public. I know this is a broad, complex issue, but is there one tip that you could give to the average consumer, a change that they could make to make their personal data more protected than it might be right now?
What I can't stress enough to my students is when you are a user of Facebook or Google, and believe me, I'm a user of Google, right? So I'm not perfect. But when you're a user of a free service, you're not a customer, you're a commodity. Your information is how they make money. It's not you showing up and using it. So you're not a customer, you're a commodity.